happening right now. You're looking at live pictures of major cities across the country where hundreds of thousands are gathering to kick off this year's Women's March in Charlotte, Denver, Chicago, and New York. Let's get to Polo Sandoval in Philadelphia. Polo, what's the scene there?
Fred, you have seen people taking to the streets all over the country. Philadelphia is certainly not an exception. Here along Benjamin Parkway, we are seeing a virtual sea of people coming together as they march towards the main venue for the speaking event. Among them, Carla Kos, who's visiting from Maryland. You came here to Philadelphia not too far away, but what is the main message? You participated recently a year ago. What's changed in the last year? What hasn't? And what's the main message today, Carla?
For me, my message isn't that much different than it was last year. I have a lot of difficulty with understanding whether Donald Trump understands that there are other opinions in this world besides his. The government is for the people that he governs, not for him. So I'm here to make that point, to say I'm here, I have a voice, I have the right to say what I need to say.
Some of the inaction from last night and lawmakers unable to reach a deal, and of course the president joining in on that as well, and its shutdown. Does that change things today at all for you? Being in a shutdown?
It changes things for me in that I have many concerns about what people are not getting as a result of the shutdown. Like today, everything is still going smoothly, so something is functioning, but there are people who are going to be looking for their Medicare checks, their Medicaid checks, their people who actually need services that the government is supposed to be providing, especially people with disabilities. These things are important for all the people in this country, not just for Donald Trump. I mean, he can take them away and give the money to ARMS if he wants to, but he actually needs to find a way to take some money and put it to the people that actually need it.
Carla Kos, thank you for taking the time. Thank you so
much. My pleasure. Thanks.
Again, just one of several participants that you'll hear from. Not only concerns, Fred, but also questions about what happens next amid this government shutdown. And of course, many of those concerns about the president, a certain reality, as Carla told me a little while ago, that he may be living in, that perhaps does not reflect many of the people here today. So that's the situation here in Philadelphia with a high turnout, certainly high security, police keeping an eye on the crowd. But things, of course, very peaceful today.
All right, Polo Sandoval in Philadelphia, thank you so much. All right, let's head a little bit north now to New York. Alex Marquardt is there. Alex, what's the scene?
Hi there, Fred. Well, it's pretty loud out here. The party is underway. The rally is about to start here in New York. We're right on the edge of Central Park on New York's Upper West Side. You can see here the crowds have started to gather, the marchers who are going to start marching in just about an hour and a half's time. This crowd goes all the way back 10 or more blocks. The march last year was around 400,000 people. So far this year, they've registered around 85,000. We are expecting more than that. Here you have people from all walks of life, mothers with their kids, fathers out here with their sons, all sorts of signs, some very colorful that we can't show you, but others a bit more appropriate for family television down here. Nevertheless, she persisted. Of course, that line from Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell about Senator Elizabeth Warren, and right next to that, I am woman, hear me roar. Now, of course, this is being called a women's march, but it is really a march that covers the gamut of issues. People out here fighting for equal rights for immigrants, for people of color, for people with disabilities, for people with different religions. And people have come from all over the place. These are not just New Yorkers. I spoke with a woman who came down here from Vermont. I spoke with a student who is from Oregon, and they were telling me that this is not just about women's rights. This is about human rights. So, Fred, what we're expecting in the next few minutes is that the rally is going to start right here in the southwest corner of Central Park. There will be speakers, including politicians, activists, some celebrities and surprise guests, and then the march will get underway around 1 p.m. and they'll march down to 43rd Street, all this wrapping up in the mid-afternoon. Fred?
All right, Alex Marquardt in New York, thank you so much. All right, let's go west, my friends, to Chicago. Ryan Young is there. Ryan, what's happening?
Hey, Fred, the program really just got underway here, and you can see the large crowds that have already started to show up here. Last year, over 200,000 people were here. You can see it stretching all the way back in the direction there. People have said they wanted to be here because they wanted to show that they wanted change, and they wanted to see change happen over some time. Look, you were here last year, you told me. What brought you back out here for a second year in a row?
Gorgeous blazers.
My daughter's future.
I think it was so awesome that last year everybody got to come together, and not just for
for their own reason, but for the fact that everybody can come together and celebrate those no matter how you feel. And so I think that really motivated us to come back this year.
What do you want your daughter to experience in terms of the future? Because I know a lot of people are talking about gender bias, they're talking about changes they want to see. What would you like to see changed in this country?
I would just like her to know that she has endless possibilities and that she's safe. And that when women and men come together, that we can create a great community and a wonderful country.
There's been a lot of conversation about the Me Too movement. How has that impacted you as being a young person seeing this?
I think it's hard sometimes for our generation to really comprehend something as serious as cases, especially not just in Hollywood, but everywhere. But I think it's important for our generation to understand that we cannot be okay with this anymore, and that we need to stand up and finally change the views and what is right and what we will tolerate.
Thank you so much for sharing with us.
Well, yeah. It will happen. It's happening.
If you see, the crowd is energized, so we're right in the middle of all this. Once again, the crowds are still gathering. We have another hour or so before we see people start marching toward the Federal Plaza. Right now we have performers on stage. So Fred, a lot of energy, a lot of people showing up. It looks like the numbers are a little down from last year, but people keep saying more people are starting to march this way.